Hello. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. I was gonna make bacon and eggs while the thing was on, starting soon. But then I went to the kitchen and I had to put dishes away. And then I had to take all the dirty dishes and put them in the thing to take them upstairs. And that just took longer than I thought. So now I'm a sad girl with no bacon and eggs. Because I got responsibilities. But I did remember to make my water. So that's something. A pinless reveal!
So excited to catch a little bit of stream before I have to
transfer. Good morning. I'm sorry that you have to go to work. I did use my bacon energy as dishes energy. Well, it also just, like, it would have taken another, like, 15 minutes. And I meant to just hit starting soon.
Yeehaw!
Good morning, you all.
And then make it. And then I went in the kitchen and I said, who left this work for me? And it was me. I did make an exclamation point Barbie. In case anyone, like, joins and thinks we're talking about, like, the Barbie movie, which we are not supposed to talk about as influencers. But we started, like, planning my Barbie birthday party, like, at the end of May. So we've been planning it separately from the movie. It is pinless. Which is not a crime. And it's not a Barbie movie themed party. It is just a Barbie themed party of regular Barbie who exists outside of the movie. But yeah, I mean, I don't think anyone would show up and be snotty. I do think people might show up and think that they are, like, telling me something I don't know out of the goodness of their heart. I'm not a fluencer, so I can talk about it all I want. You can. I think everyone in the comments can talk about it as much as they want. And I'm happy for you. I started How to Sell a Haunted House yesterday, but then I had a nightmare about it, and it's not even the scariest part. I really want to read How to Sell a Haunted House. But I have not yet. Here's what I'm thinking we'll do. I need to make a to-do list, which we all love to do together. And then after that, I need to work on my costume, which shouldn't be super hard. But I do think that it needs to get done, number one. And then number two, I figured we might as well do it together. So that didn't seem so bad. What else did y'all do? We were off yesterday. I think my plan right now, let me fix our schedule while I'm thinking about it. I think our plan right now, sorry, I was making sure it wasn't going to play twice, is we have no stream this Saturday because it's my actual birthday. It's the day of our party. And then I think, because we're leaving next Wednesday, to go on vacation. So I think my plan right now is we will have an unusual Monday stream that I might make my, like, birthday stream. It'd technically be after my birthday, but I don't have time to do it this week because I'm too busy planning for my birthday party. My little one is that it's my birthday week. Our friend Lemon made me an advent calendar for my birthday, which I was like, this is a great gift because I'll get a little present every day. Dear reader, I didn't last that long. For, like, the first week, I did really good about only opening one present every day. Unfortunately, I'm very impatient and I opened all the rest. But they're all really cute. Thank you. My other little win is that Phoebe's loving Fourth Wing. Yesterday, guess how many hours we listened to Fourth Wing? The answer is 5.5 hours worth. Just like a regular advent calendar. I am playing a truly worrying amount of Stardew. You gave dragons to an autistic. What did you think was gonna happen? Phoebe remembers the dragons way more than I did. When I was reading anything about the dragons, which this is not a spoiler because everybody knows that dragons are in Fourth Wing, and I'm not gonna talk about like specifics. But like throughout the course of the book, there's like little things about each type of dragon. And Phoebe remembers them way better than I do. Because anytime I would get to them, I would just kind of skim over them and be like, I'm never going to remember this, so. I don't remember which one's a feathered tail and which one's a such and such and what you have to do when you see those. Sorry. I also feel like I really like it because if you are, like, not a fantasy person, I feel like it's really good for people who don't normally read fantasy, because the reason I feel like fantasy is typically daunting is because the first like 2 hours I feel like of every fantasy novel is like world building. And so like you'll start a new fantasy book and she'll be like, I'm Megan Tyranno Sassafras. My father was Mark Tyranno Sassafras. I'm, 82nd in a line of 117 people in line for the throne. You know what I mean? Fourth Wing, here's a fact about the dragon beeper. Write that down, write that down. Megan, I was trying so hard to not say Megan the Stallion. No, literally Penless. Yeah, so I can't normally keep up. Now, if it has a map and Beau read, I forget the name of it, the Locked Tomb series, I think, like Gideon the Ninth. And at the beginning of those books, they have like a character list, essentially, that tells you who each person is. And I was like, every fantasy book needs this. If they had given me a little sheet at the beginning of Game of Thrones, I would have gotten into it years before I did. What I hope someone makes a Fourth Wing is, like, similar to our little mushroom thing back here, which I've just realized you can't really see because it's too far away from you. But it's, like, you know, you've all seen a chart like this. It's got, like, different types of mushrooms with, like, the name under them. I want someone to make something like this of the Fourth Wing dragons. Which, honestly, someone could have, and I wouldn't know. Let me see. Fourth Wing. I'm not putting this big in case there's spoilers. Fourth Wing dragon... types? Maybe? Oof. Okay, we've got one. It's not exactly what I mean, but it is close. It's just the tails, the different types of tails. Which is cute. I love referencing back to the map. Same. Throne of Glass has a pronunciation guide in the back? Does it really? Yes. Also a dictionary terms with all... Yes. I don't mind you living in a fantasy world. That's what I thought we were getting into. But I don't live there. So can you give me a little dictionary? Good morning. There are pictures of dragons on the cover. We love a glossary. Yes, that's also my only complaint, Arrow. I'll still do it. I'll tap all the way back. But that is my only complaint about reading with a Kindle. And if you know what page things are on, you can like skip to that page by like going faster at the bottom. But obviously I don't know what page it's on. Fourth Wing is the first book in the series, to be clear. It's the only one that's out. So if you don't know anything about it, that's good, because it's the first one. Those Dragon Fae Encyclopedia. I don't know what you're talking about. Then there's Fifth Wing. Luna, I have never used Highlight. I'm too nervous. Where do the highlights go? Do they show up on my Goodreads? Because here's the thing. What if I highlight something sexy? I don't want everybody knowing what sexy parts I highlight. Penless, you can do that on the Kindle for normal words. And you can also, when you do it, it'll show you, like, other sentences that word's been in, I think, in the book. I just misread the price of Fourth Wing is 100 euros, but it's 10, no, pounds, no. 10 pounds. Almost all the sexy words that show up for me in a quarter of blank are highlighted. I think too hard about it. It's the symbol that throws me off. And I'm reading something and it's like the introduction of a character and it's like 1,050 people have highlighted this. Oh, I have mine turned off. I always say pounds and then I see a little symbol which I feel looks like an E and then I'm like, fuck. And then I'm like, wait. No, euros are in Europe, but not where 7 is. You can. Mine doesn't do that anymore. I don't remember where I turned it off. They both look like E's, Cozy. Do you see how it's confusing for my little tiny American brain? Yes. Mess with your Kindle settings or Google it, but you can turn it off because mine doesn't do that anymore. I also turned off WordWise, I think it is. I turned it on by accident, and it was horrible. And then I had to turn it off. Penlez, you're saying people like people don't live there, and instead geese live there. The people of Britain. The geese of Britain. Anyway, that's what we're up to. Okay, let's make our to-do list. Number one, one thing about me is let's make a to-do list. I am just making it on Google Docs, everyone. I'm just making fun of the British as my God-given right. Have we confirmed it's not mainly geese? We haven't. One of our favorite games to play is, as you all know, we're best friends with Seven, Armand. And one of our favorite games to play is we'll be doing something and we'll be like, when Seven visits, it's going to lose its mind. Or when we visit Seven in the place where Seven lives, which is in the British place, loosely, we will lose our mind. United Goose Commonwealth. You guys better watch out. When I get to London, it's literally over for you guys. I'm gonna have so many little British boyfriends. It's not my business to tell everyone where Seven lives. I do know, to be clear, loosely, but it's not my business. Is Untitled Goose Game really just a documentary of Seven's life? I've already put in my pre-retirement. You tell me when you're going and it's officially over. Listen. It'll be a blast. I think the other thing is, like, as we've noticed, as we all know from being on stream, it's like there are random things that, like, I don't think about that are definitely, like, distinctly American. That I feel like will be quite a shock, you know? Morgan London. It'll be like Emery and Paris. Why did I say Emery? Emily and Paris. Like your 6,000 regional burger chains? Hey, and you're right, and I'm proud to be an American. Seven will be like, why is mac and cheese under vegetables on this restaurant menu? And I'll be like, it's a vegetable. What do you mean? The vegetables are mac and cheese, green beans, sweet potato casserole, and steamed broccoli. Those are the vegetables at the restaurant. Mashed potatoes. So true. They don't have corn at every restaurant. Oh my god, Phoebe, I don't know if this is true. I would like to start there. I might be spreading misinformation. Phoebe's dad told us the other day that, like, the noise you think of when you think of a screeching eagle is not actually an eagle. It's like the red-tailed hawk or something. And an eagle sounds much more like, I don't remember what he said.
A seagull.
A seagull. Everyone says this is true.
Yeah, Dad heard it on a podcast.
Okay, that doesn't mean anything.
Some people lie, and that's you. And other people don't, and that's Dad.
They sound better. They do. Were you thinking about making breakfast? Oh, he's sad. Oh, he's so sad. My sad little Muppet husband. Oh, no, he's dead. It's very sad for me.
I don't want to make... I'm not making bacon.
I know. America wants to sound cooler than we are.
Do you want flat eggs?
I could have flat eggs. Look up how the red-tailed hawk sound. Okay, hang on. Can I do that? Red-tailed hawk calling. Okay. Oh, this is 45 seconds. The red-tailed hawk and the bald eagle. Hang on. It might be really loud. I'm going to turn it down. That's the red tail. This is a bald eagle. Hey, why is he just singing? Yes, I'm a bird nerd. Chirpy chirp chirp! Is this the start of my bird hyperfixation? That's true, they're not bald. I've never understood why they're called the bald eagle. Did they look bald at the beginning when the people couldn't see them really close?
It's because their head is white.
No, but it's not bald.
No, but the rest of them's brown. They're bald of their brown feathers.
Oh, they're brown feather bald.
Yeah.
You look like a beautiful little Greek man.
You are a mean girl. Leave me alone, please.
I like your little toga made of bed sheets.
Thank you. I'd have to find a brassiere.
Oh, no. I am technically brown feather bald. It's because it looks bald, so everyone was like, hey, Baldy! Phoebe is in their Socrates era. They go bald? Because their feathers turn white and their heads are babies. Wait, because their feathers turn white, their heads as babies are brown. Oh! They go bald of their brown feathers from baby to adult. And then adult says, we'll put some white feathers here. I don't know what you mean, Pinlas. Stop. Their heads are babies. Learning so much about birds and dragons this morning. That's true. They're related. I need y'all to know I'm not kidding. At least once a week, I'm like, maybe one day dragons will be real. And they shouldn't be, because I've seen Jurassic Park. But similar to my problem with men, I think I can fix them. I will be Daenerys. And if you make dragons real, I'll be able to talk to them. Me, famously outdoorsy and good with animals. I could do it. Can you grab me a blob? You don't have one underground?
No.
They can't see you over there.
I'm scared. Can you please?
Oh my god.
I've been traumatized from when they saw my breasts in
the head. They didn't see your breasts. They have to pay for the privilege. Oh my god. Okay, here's your teeny tiny one.
My green one?
Oh my god. If you had so many pennies, you sure can't got it.
I can't because then they'll see me. Can you throw me my pants also?
I can't reach your pants.
Thank you.
Thank you, anonymous gifter. That's very sweet. Should I do a little... Should I do AI live streaming but on Twitch? I didn't get the tier 3 sub, so I got a blurred sneak peek of the breast. It's not an official one. Listen, we could become like those girlies who stream from their shower. Which they're allowed to do, I guess. Okay, Barbie party to do. We have to go... Hey, I don't want this bold. We have to go grocery shopping. Oh, that's so good. I have to finish my costume. Phoebe's working on their costume today, I think. We have to clean up the Barbies we bought. Oh, that's so good. This might get confusing fast. That's so rude, Hannah. I think they do. The person who, like, started the trend of doing the AI TikTok live streams is literally doing it to promote her Shrek's work. And then the people who did it as, like, a trend, I don't think they know, but I don't think they care. I can't see Barbie because I will literally be saying he's literally me about Alan for the rest of my life. I wish I could comment. Never heard of it. Okay, I gotta clean up the Barbies we bought for decor. Hang on, let's make this. Here we go. Don't even worry about it. I'm on it, and now everyone will be able to read. Literally typing out exactly what Morgan said. That's crazy. I've never even heard of a movie. At my house, we just... read books and imagine them in our heads. Everybody drink your water. Okay. Tutu Barbie. My outfit's not prepped. That's what finished costume is. Which we are gonna do today after I make this to-do list. We need to clean our bathroom. I also have to clean the backyard, which I'll do, I think I'm supposed to do it this afternoon. What are movies? Never seen one. Adventure Erin, I love Most Popular Girls in School, which is not struck work because it was just some person at their house. We also need to... finish the Barbie box, which shouldn't take long. Mom did most of the work. Oh, I need to clean out, or let's see, clean off. I made a Barbie Land sign. I'm debating if I'm gonna paint it the way it's painted somewhere else. I think think I'm gonna leave it white, because then it really looks like the Hollywood sign. You know? Haha, Pinlez, you should see the comments on other people's things. People are mean. I would say the benefit, though, of, like, the recent things that have happened that I can't comment on is that we went on a walk the other day, and, like, five kids were like, I love your hair. And I don't know, thank you, Kayla. I don't know if it's because of, like, recent films that may or may not have come out. But I've had this hair for a while, and I don't know if the kids are just now noticing it in our neighborhood on our walks. If they just think the color pink was just invented, I don't know. But it was, I was like, do you think this is the opposite of misogyny? Is that why the kids suddenly love my hair in the neighborhood? Kids can't see pink until they're 9. Aaron, that's so cute. Mom's doing, she's calling it a tablescape, which is really cute. We also need to make the cups. We bought a bunch of tumbler cups. And Mom bought the Barbie font. And we're, like, making tumbler cups with people's names in the Barbie font. Pinlez, to be fair, I don't think people are having other movie parties. But, like, in everything that I've said a little bit about it, I'm like, this is a general, that's why I made a command about it. This has nothing to do with any films. This is just a Barbie trademark Mattel party, which I played with as a baby. Nothing to do with. This has been planned for months before I knew that there would be mayhaps controversy around this party theme. I've never seen a film. I don't know what you're talking about. I mean, Pinlez, to be clear, like, it's what we signed up for as our job, you know? Like, people, I need you to know that, like, most of our job, especially Phoebe's, is just deleting mean comments of people who either don't get us or, like, think that we have different values than them, or, you know, that's just what our job is like. People have a lot of opinions on what we do. Stop, Hannah, is that true? Okay, I need to finish cleaning our part of the house. I just always say apartment. We still live in a house. But I feel like I call our section our apartment. Wouldn't Barbie melt? People think being rude is a hobby these days. They really do. I think that's it. Finished costume. I'm also going to add and hat, because the hat is the problem I'm having. Your basement apartment that is not an apartment or in the basement. So true. Or in Portland. I kind of want to make something to go on the front door. But I don't know if that's a bit too, like, much. I also need to make a grocery list, but I'm not doing that on stream. A Barbie wreath. Listen, I want to. Phoebe is making a Barbie crown. Out of Barbies. Because we're doing a costume contest. And the winner will be getting a crown made out of Barbie heads. It's only too much if you don't want to do it. Oh, I just think it'll be boring. And I'm much more interested in working on my costume. I think that's it. Which is actually not that bad. Now, however, this has nothing to do with what they have to do upstairs. Oh, I do have to clean out the kitchen upstairs. I haven't gone through the cabinet since we moved in. You know, and so there's like chips that have expired and things like that. Was it themed or made out of Barbies? Both. It will be made out of Barbies, though. Oh, I also have to make my cake. Which I'll be doing the classic early 2000s Barbie dress cake. Where you put a Barbie inside of it and it's just a bunch of circle pans. You know what I mean? Which won't be enough, so I'm also gonna buy iconic. I always wanted one as a little kid, I never got one. So we bought a like Barbie that has pink hair and blue eyes. Thank you. That's what the party's about, is healing your inner child. It is not about the film. It was timed with the film on purpose because I knew there would be plenty of Barbie things to buy. But I got one for my 18th birthday after much begging. That's so cute. They're so cute. I never had one. I'm very excited. And I also have to make mac and cheese. One thing about me, if there's a potluck, I'm making mac and cheese. It turns out here in the Pacific Northwest, people don't ever make mac and cheese for anything. And where I come from, any event, there's going to be mac and cheese. There's going to be mac and cheese. There's going to be potatoes. There's going to be sweet tea. They don't have those here. They hate them, I guess. Barbara's named after Ruth Handler's daughter Barbara, and Ken is after her son Kenneth. That's so funny. Yeah. Anytime I go to a family potluck here, nobody makes mac and cheese. They're always like, I made loose ground beef. I made a pie. Mac and cheese forever. For life. Loose ground beef. People, like, at least Phoebe's family. And it's not a bad idea because, honestly, like, since everyone makes their own, it's pretty good for, like, diets. They'll make, like, loose ground beef and it make, like, a taco bar. And then we'll also make, like, loose vegetarian ground beef. And then everyone kind of puts whatever they want on their little taco. So, like, Phoebe doesn't like cheese. They don't have to eat cheese like that. And then someone will also bring, like, little slices of steak a lot. There's usually rolls. Maybe deviled eggs if Bo makes them because Bo really likes deviled eggs. And, like, three desserts. As someone who also lives in Oregon, salad is way more common than mac and cheese for potlucks. Yes! I don't know what it is. people where I'm from, what I should have done was assign things to people, because here's what I want. Pigs in a blanket, mac and cheese, mashed potatoes, green beans, your aunt's ambrosia salad. The regional differences amuse me. We don't have potluck in the UK. Do you call it something else? Do you have a name for if you're hosting a party and you tell everyone to bring a dish and then we'll all share? Baked beans, homemade potato salad. I bring stuffing to every party because no one knows they want it outside of winter until I make it. No, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's why they're better, for sure, is because of black people. And there are way more black people in the South. A dinner party, I guess? Ambrosia salad. When I was a kid, so ambrosia, the term is Greek, right? Ambrosia, Greek mythology. Yeah, it's the food or drink of the Greek gods. An ambrosia salad, by the way, not salad, is Cool Whip. It's like a fruit salad with Cool Whip. Creamy fruit salad loaded with pineapple, mandarin oranges, coconut, and miniature fruit-flavored marshmallows. Carrions. Frog eye salad. I also feel like I'm trying to think of... I have no idea what people are going to bring. No, they're really serious about baked beans in the UK, right? Where I am from, baked beans come from a can, and then sometimes people add, like, brown sugar to them. Or barbecue sauce, like honey barbecue. Oh, I've never had Snickers salad. You hate baked beans? I love baked beans. Barbecue baked beans go hard. Pinless, what other baked beans do you have? Because we only have barbecue. I'm not British, no comment. Are there other kinds of baked beans? That's fine, Echo. Some people don't like green beans. I don't mind lima beans the way some people hate them. Tomato? That's so you have like ketchup baked beans? It is the de facto most common bean. Y'all are lying. Tomato baked beans are good. They sell them at Trader Joe's. No, baked beans, baked beans is barbecue baked beans in the U.S. If you were to say baked beans, that's what people are thinking of. Heinz baked beans. That's ketchup, baby. Here we go. Now, to be fair, they look the same. Heinz baked beans. Let me explain up front. This recipe is for British-style baked beans, which comes in a semi-clear tomato sauce and is traditionally served for breakfast. It's completely different from Southern baked beans. We get Heinz mayo and salad cream, all sorts. Now, Paper, while I believe you, if you were to say I'm bringing baked beans to a party, nobody would think you were bringing anything besides barbecue baked beans. What the fuck is salad cream? Okay, here's all the ingredients to this person's. Navy beans, sugar, ketchup, chicken broth water, corn flour, tomato paste, Worcestershire, vinegar, onion, garlic, salt, pepper. They colonized the Western world to put beans on toast. Salad cream, isn't that just ranch? I'm Googling salad cream also. Because what is salad cream? Oh, what is salad cream? What do you do with it? iHeartBritain.com is going to tell us. Don't you worry. Dear reader, it is worse than I thought. Can you see it? Hang on. What is this? Thanks, iHeartBritain.com sponsored today's stream. Is it not? Are y'all ready to read this? The Brits around here may be a bit mystified by this post, but bear with us because it's a topic that comes up from time to time in emails and our Facebook groups. If you've traveled in the UK or watched a lot of British television, you may have encountered a mysterious substance called salad cream. It sounds a bit like something you'd massage into your lettuce, but for the uninitiated, its purpose isn't entirely clear. I've never massaged my lettuce. Okay, but this doesn't answer anything. You definitely can put it on salads, but market research in the UK suggests only around 14% of people actually do. It's used to be considerably more common. It used to be considerably more common, but these days salad eaters have a lot more options. What do you use salad cream for? It's versatile. It's very similar to ranch dressing for many Americans. Not at all similar in taste. Frequently used on sandwiches, similar to how you might use mayonnaise or another sandwich spread. Oh, okay. It's also used on jacket potatoes, so it's not similar. Jersey royal potatoes. Chips or a chip buddy. Fish sandwich. So it is, that's what she means by it's similar to ranch. Chip buddies where you put fries in a sandwich. Love it. I don't know what jacket potato is. Oh, yes I do. It's, fuck, what are they called? Baked potatoes? It's a baked potato. The foil is the jacket. My mother used it a lot to mix with tuna to put in sandwiches. So that's what they mean by it's similar to ranch. Not in taste, but she means what they use it for. Because similar to ranch in our house, and I feel in a lot of American homes, if you have ranch in your fridge, you're not using it for salad. Rarely are you using it for salad. You're dipping your pizza in it. You're dipping your fries in it. It's not mayonnaise. I think the consistency seems to be the same as mayonnaise. Like you can squeeze it out of a squeezy bottle. They use it how I use ranch. Ranch is not quite garlic mayo. I feel like it's creamier than that. You're drinking it. I can't get over they dip fruit in it. Salad cream is a bad name, but now they've got me interested. I'm loving iHeartBritain.com. Here's the website. Hang on. Let me make it less like this. I gotta find out more. Okay, here's I Heart Britain. Should we do latest post or British store? Chief Mouser. Seven, what it said was that people dip it in, dip fruit in it. I guess I like ranch with Hawaiian pizza, so I can see how someone would dip fruit in it. That's true. Just how 10 Downing Street has Chief Mouser, so does iHeartBritain.com. Cat Caddington, I henceforth refer to as Cat Cat, is a creature of mysterious origins. This is a cat. That feels like a rich people thing. All right, anyway, home. Let's do latest post. The Mystery of Stonehenge. Bookshops in London. Why do British people bring grapes to the hospital? What? That is an unexpected question. Finally, some real journalism. I would never think twice about someone bringing grapes to a hospital. Is it a thing? Let's find out. The simple answer is this: tradition. Bringing grapes to the hospital is one of those things people have been doing for so long at this point, many don't know why. I've never brought grapes to the hospital or had anyone bring grapes to the hospital. We click on it, says no, we're asking why. Grapes were once a luxury item. Who are these people talking to? Do you guys think that she's clearly American, right? And she's just into British culture. Not a crime, whatever. Do you think she's just interviewing British people and they're just lying? Yeah, I don't know what Lucozade is. Lucozade? Lucozade. Is it like Gatorade? No, it was from May something. Isotonic drink. Sports drink, like Gatorade. It's from May 2nd. It's not lies. You can't lie on the internet. Oh, hey, here it is. Scroll down a little bit. Lucozade, a guide to this distinctly British beverage. It says energy on it. I love that she writes about British people like a Nat Geo author studying a weird bird. It makes sense to be good for hangovers. I know a lot of people drink Pedialyte after a hangover. 19 uniquely British crisp flavors to try. What is Robert Burns Night and why do people celebrate it? Over here you can see them dipping their fruit in salad cream. I'm very curious about salad cream now. We don't have liquid coffee creamer here. We can only get powdered coffee, mate. That's horrible. That's so sad. That's very sad for you. So you don't have flavors? No, you must have like Tirani. Like syrups. That's very sad. I love coffee creamer. Burns Night is not British. I think it's Scottish. Hey, no, this girl's a journalist. She'd never lie. We have syrups, but no creamers. I mean, the syrups, honestly, if you have that, at least you're not like... She cracked the grape case. She would never lie to us. Come on, that's ridiculous. Okay, hang on. I'm gonna change into the beginnings of my Barbie costume. I'd like to be clear that I have on a bra and shorts. Let's start there. Daylight, you got me running on daylight. Oh my God. Okay. Here's the beginnings of my twirling ballerina Barbie costume. This is just a really tight little tagging shirt. This is my skirt that I'm gonna shorten. Let me pull up a picture of her. I have on a bra right now, to be clear. Let's see. Twirling ballerina Barbie. And what I need is a picture of her. Let's see. Can I do open image in new tab? Nice.
Hello.
Yay!
This has seasonings. There are no bugs.
I don't believe you. Thank you.
All right. You look very cutesy.
Thank you.
How's your skirt smell?
Oh, it's better. I like fixed it, I think. Oh. Yeah, when I got my skirt from Amazon, because here's what happened. I was like, I'll just make it out of tulle, not a big deal. I've done it before. I don't know if you guys have bought tulle, but if you're fat, it's really fucking expensive to make a tulle skirt. So I bought one from Amazon. You know, it is what it is. And did it show up? Nice. And so I bought one for $20, $25, something like that. And it showed up, you know, quickly. Now, I think it's probably bigger than I should have bought it. I probably should have bought it a little tighter. Exactly. Okay. Come on, Barbie, let's go, Barney. Perfect. Here she is in all her glory. We probably don't need her little feet, right? That's what she's gonna look like. That's what I'm gonna look like. I don't know, you can see her little crown, which is the issue I'm having. My first issue, actually, is this is like a super stretchy top, so it started like really small. And I need to figure out how to glue these little pieces of vinyl like onto it. So, like, here is the vinyl that I have, which is kind of perfect. It's, like, got a little bit of, like, a blue underneath it. And I think it is sticky. But obviously, like, this material is, like, super stretchy. I don't think it's going to stick to it. So I think I'm going to have to glue it. But the problem is, this is a really sticky thing. Oh, it doesn't stick. There is iron-on holographic. That's not what I bought. Okay, this is what it looks like. See how you can kind of see me through it? That's what I'm thinking. Like, Amy, that's my problem. Have Beaver put it on and just point a heat gun at you. I think I'm either going to have to glue it while it's stretched out on me. You see what I'm saying? It's because it's super stretchy. Or do I go see if I can thrift? The problem is this is a perfect shirt. I know hers doesn't look like this, but I'm an adult and I'm sexy. I do need a Morgan-sized mannequin. Oh, because I don't want to spend any more money. That would be why. But I do see what you're saying. Like, put holographic underneath and then just cut holes in this. But if it was fishnet on top, I'd still have to stretch it out to glue it. You know what I mean? Here's what I'm currently thinking. This is like a dress. There's no underneath part. So I think if, when I'm getting into it, I basically take a piece of cardboard and shove it like between me, like between my underneath and the shirt. Does that make sense? And then glue it on top. That might work. What I'm about to do right now is cut a little triangle piece for us to try. Or a diamond-sized piece. Oh, the other thing I need to do today is I'm going to shorten this skirt. I'm also not hemming it. I'm literally just chopping it. Because I don't need it to be perfect. And then with the extra tool on the bottom, I'm going to sew to my little top. That's my plan. Tokens in hand. I got no respect because I'm the new man. Got my shovel, shoes full of sand. Check out the tag, the name's Caveman. All right. Yeah, I probably won't do that. To be clear, I would much rather make it much harder for myself and have it be more accurate. Call it attention to detail. All right, let's see. That is your right as a Leo. Thank you. All right, we've got a vague diagonal shape here. The other thing is, since my nails are so long, which I'm getting them done on Thursday, so that is good, but they're way too long, it makes it really hard to peel stuff. The Holes song has been stuck in my head for days. And I used to know all the words when I was younger. Dig it up, dig it. Dig it up, Why was it so good? Two tokens in hand. I got no respect because I'm the new man. Got my shovel, shoes full of sand. Check out the tag, the name's Caveman. I've been singing Girl Dinner for a week. Girl Dinner's good. Bro, please, bro. I'm begging you to just separate. Oh, I got like two videos with Tism Riz. One of them is including the artist, though. Oh my god, come on, bro. Come on. So close. We're almost there, I can feel it. What I need is like a professional person who's really good at peeling things. Oh, oh. Here we go. All right. I don't know if you can see it that well. Now, the other thing I thought about is sewing it while it's on me. Which isn't impossible, because all I'm going to do is do little, like, whip stitches at the corner. You know? ASD abilities. You are in jail. I don't know. That, I mean, it wouldn't be that hard, especially because now she's wearing hers a lot lower, I guess, which is true. Oh, that's not a bad idea. And guide with fabric markers. Fabric glue was the other thought that I had. But this is like, I don't know if it would work. But what if I did like super glue? What I need is like a practice round. But I think you get the idea. I think it'll be really cute. Now, while we're sitting here, I am going to cut out all my little diamonds. Let me move my little trash can closer. That's what I'm thinking. I don't plan on wearing it again. That was the other fear that I had, Seven. Oh my god, I dropped him already. That's what I am thinking also. Is that I would need to sew it and wear it. Or stretch it out on like a huge piece of cardboard. I don't know. I got thoughts. They're multiplying. Step one, make a full body cast of yourself out of duct tape. So true. And when you're right, you're right. I think pillows would not be enough. When I take this off, I'll show you how small the shirt is. Step two, profit. It's really small. Oh, no, Echo, it's the worst. I'm sorry. You stay there. Now, the other thing is this is not going to be perfect. A true one-size-fits-all shirt. Now, when we got this, it says sizes 1 to 4X. And I was like, okay. If I use super glue on my body, how would I injure myself? Just by being sticky, you know? That's not an injury. You can wash super glue off with oil. I'm also getting in the hot tub that day. I feel like that would melt the super glue off. A chemical burn? Now say that to my husband, because when Phoebe gets a cut on their hand, guess what they use to stop it from bleeding? It's super glue. Spoiler alert. This will be on the B team. That one's not that good. The hot tub will fix the chemical burn. Okay, I lost all my stuff. Thank you. Listen, I don't think they should be allowed to use super glue. Please, I'm concerned. That is certainly inventive. Yes. Phoebe's dad does it. And Phoebe was like, this is basically what they use at the ER. And while they're not wrong, they also are much smarter at the ER than we are at our home. Listen, do we think fabric glue would matter if it got on my skin, though? I just feel like fabric glue is not gonna be, smart enough. Not smart, but, serious enough. Me, personally, I use a Band-Aid. Thank you. Now, unfortunately, what I've done is made all of the diamonds really uneven. But I feel like you won't be able to tell. You know? You can't really tell that these points aren't exactly even. Not when I'm moving around, being the birthday girl. I do too, but it's gonna take so much longer. But I think it would be the least invasive option. I steal vet wrap from work instead of Band-Aids. They won't see it, but you'll be twirling. I think it'll take the longest, but it'll be the most comfortable. I agree. Beaver's not going as Alan. Beaver is going as Ken. I think they would go as Alan if it was easier to make Alan's costume. But they would need to, make it. You know what I mean? They couldn't just, thrift the pieces for it, really. We're going for accuracy in our house. Beeper is just an Alan. Beeper just is an Alan. And you're right. Okay, I'm gonna try and make one that's less wompy jog. Oh, Oh, I made it even more wumpy jog. He is incredibly wumpy jog. Okay, I'm throwing that one away. That's how bad it is. It's not a polo. It's a terry cloth shirt. With a zipper that goes both ways. Boo work. Do you see what I'm saying? That sucks, Echo. I'm sorry. Bieber skins, buddy. All his clothes fit them. Okay, I'm fixing this. I'm fixing this once and for all. I made it worse. I made it so much worse. Okay. All right. I looked into doing an Alan costume and I gave up really quick. I don't know. He doesn't have a boyfriend. He's Ken's buddy. What do you mean? He's Ken's buddy and all his clothes fit him. Very normal. Very standard. Okay. I've got to fix this. I'm making way too many Wompy Jog diamonds here. That is fair, Oko. I don't want to talk about it too much because I don't want to stress anyone out in chat. I'm very excited for you. I've never even heard of a movie. I've never been to the movies in my life. Check normie life. What's a movie? Never even. It's like a moving book. That's so weird. The last movie that ever came out was Jurassic Park 3. So true. And when you're right, you're right. Oh my god, you're not in trouble. I thought it was Detective Pikachu. What's a movie like a long TikTok? Yeah, that's what I heard. Hello, Ghost Boy. Welcome. Welcome in. I'm working on my Barbie costume before my birthday party. Longer than a YouTube video, shorter than a Twitch stream. Not around here. Oh my god, did y'all see the person? I put it on our close friend story. But on Threads, this person just like wanted to fight us for no reason, I guess. So like, I don't even know. I don't know why people want to fight us so badly. But I threaded. I don't know what we're supposed to say. I put out a thread. Because it's like where we're least, where we have the least amount of followers. So I didn't feel like it was like breaking any rules because we're not like influencers there. Also I was doing the opposite of promoting. Oh, sorry. My fit check's not real because this is me working on my costume now. And I said, like, I don't even know, like, I have no desire to see Oppenheimer, and I don't even know what it's about, and at this point I'm too afraid to ask, essentially. And they responded. By saying, like, but I bet you went to see Barbie, like, fucking idiot, essentially. And I was like, okay, don't care. Whatever. By the way, like, looking at their profile picture, I don't think they're a man. I think they're the wife in that picture. And then someone responded to them and said, be nice, please. And then they said, like, no, I bet you don't even know who, like, J. Robert Oppenheimer is. Like, go be a grown-up and see a three-hour movie. And then I responded to them and said, like, babe, I think it's time to turn your phone off because you're being mean to people on the internet about a movie that will make plenty of money with or without us. And they responded to me and they said, no, you need to be a grown-up and turn off your phone to see a three-hour movie. And then I said, it's weird how you have time to see a three-hour movie but not enough time to remove the stick from your ass. No, literally. It is war propaganda, and you should say it. And then I blocked them. Because I was like, I'm not fucking dealing with that. What the fuck is wrong with people? I hate to tell you this. That man, I assume, is dead. And the film, I assume, has a lot of fictional elements. Why would I watch 3 hours of someone saying war is good? Supposedly it's about, like, that man's regrets about helping build the atomic bomb. And I'm hearing that. But I actually think that I, at the beginning, would have been like, maybe I don't want to make this. Instead of waiting to make it first and then having regrets. You know? That's just me. Maybe I'm built different. Maybe I'm the weirdo. No, literally. What I was trying to do was very similar to the Parks and Rec joke, which I'm sure didn't originate it, but where Andy's like, I don't know what something something is, and at this point I'm too afraid to ask. Because the joke is like, people, I don't understand why other people are excited about it. I guess. I was like, why do you want to fight me? I agree, Seven. I feel like anything that's glorifying, not even, anything that's talking about it, there's, even if their main character is like, I don't think war is good, like, people in the movie are. Such a weird thing to pick a fight about, especially with someone you don't follow. Like, how did they even get to my thread? Because you can't search terms, so, like, that means that they must know someone who does follow me. And liked it, or, you know. So really, this wouldn't exist if 9/11 never happened. Is he in it? Oh, did Christopher Nolan do Batman? I'm very confused. Oh, yeah, for sure. I've never been, like, the fight with someone on the internet type. Also, I'd just rather not spend 3 hours of my life watching something I'm not jazzed to see. Nolan is the Dark Knight, which Robert Pattinson is not in. In case you were wondering. Tenet. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, good for them. I hope the movie is good. I hope people who are into it have a good time. I feel like talking about it isn't promoting it because I'm not going. Wasn't he in The Notebook? Oh, my plan right now is just wing it. You know? My plan is to make the ones I'm making, and then I think I'm going to fold them in half and make them even after that. If you have 3 hours to sit and watch a movie, especially a movie you're not interested in, good for you. Not to intrude on the Leo-ing. So true, bestie. Listen, I'm sure it'll be good. Like, I don't know. It just seems weird to argue with a stranger about on the internet when, like, number one, we're not really supposed to be talking about it. Because, like, of the strike. And then number two, it just seems really weird to argue with someone who was like, I'm not interested in seeing it. Eating out of artwork. Oh. No, literally. Yes, it will be. Me personally, I see a movie and then maybe put it on my letterbox. I do not go online to argue about it. And I'll argue about it in my home or with, like, people I know in real life. If I feel that strongly, maybe. Probably not. But, like, babes. Trying to get someone to not watch a movie with my One Wild and Precious Life. I mean, they were trying to get me to watch it. The way that they said it, they said, like, oh, what they said to the first person, that's what it was. Is they said, like, I'm sure you spend 3 hours every day scrolling online looking at garbage, so you'll be fine. Yes, yes. They said it like you have to go see it. And I was like, no one has to go see anything. Stop being fucking mean to my friends on the internet. Like, what? Sorry your life's so sad that you just want to fight with strangers on the internet, but... Me, actually? Now I'm not going just to spite you. Also, like, correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't it a movie about a white man who, like, made something for war? I don't care. I don't care. Aren't there enough white men movies? Why do you want to go online and fight people? Get a job. Like, get a hobby, you know? A different one, I guess. I guess maybe this is their hobby. I think the other thing is, like, I saw that Sparrow argued with them. I didn't know that Myth or other people had. So true, Kaya. He should feel bad. He killed a lot of people. Right. It's seeming like the natural consequences of his actions. But yeah, I don't know. I just don't get a lot of... I usually am just like a block and say nothing kind of person. And that's what I've done with most of the threads, but this one just... It blew me away too much. Because I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? It's like they want me to feel bad for him feeling bad. No, literally, I don't. I don't feel bad. And I don't feel bad for being mean to a person who's being mean to my friends. Just fucking don't do that. Ow, that hurt. Good morning. This baby will devastate nations? I don't know. I don't know if it's an... It can't be an age thing. Right? Hello? Like, I don't know. It can't all be an age thing, I guess. I do feel like I argued with people online a lot when I was, like, 22. They should make a movie about a nice scientist. But maybe I'm the exception. Like, I just don't understand. I saw someone say, come back as, can you just shut up for an hour? And I feel like that would be fitting here. Some people really, really are unhinged online. Oh no. Is there a Flubber tune? I want a movie about the furries that made the COVID vaccines. That doesn't surprise me. Isn't that what Honey, I Shrunk the Kids is about? You're not wrong. I'm just a wee creature. It's just, I don't know, man. I just feel like, maybe it is age, but I'm always like, me being mean to someone online, it doesn't really make me feel any better. It doesn't really make the person change their opinions. So, like, who is it for? They should make a new Honey, I Shrunk the Kids movie. They should pay their actors better. And then make it. I don't know. I'm team breakfast. Because I love breakfast food. Now, I've unfortunately made an error. Oh! Maybe not. Okay, hang on. It's still not great, but... Rick Moranis quit acting to raise his kids, didn't he? I could be wrong, but the people I see be most mean on the internet is people in their 50s and teenagers. This person that was being mean to Sweet Peas yesterday seemed to be in their 20s, I would guess. And I just don't know how to be like, are you really arguing with people at your big age? Have you considered getting a life, buddy? I did it again. You'll never believe it. Hello, Kaylee. We're talking about someone who was being snotty on Threads yesterday. Basically, I said, like, I was trying to make a joke similar to... I know they say it on Parks and Rec, but I'm sure it's not originally from there. But one of the characters is like... I don't remember what the actual line is, but he says, like, I don't know what ba-ba-ba is, and at this point I'm too afraid to ask. The bit being, like, whatever he's talking about is, like, too confusing for his little brain. And so now he's just not gonna ask. And I said, because we're not, like, influencers over there, we don't have, like, that kind of following, you know? But I said, like, I have no interest in seeing Oppenheimer. I don't even really know what it's about, and at this point, I'm too afraid to ask. That being the joke, and then this person got on there and was being snotty to someone else who said, like, I'm just not interested in, like, a three-hour bummer, which is true. And they said, like, oh, please, I'm sure you scroll and see lots of garbage on your feed every day for more than 3 hours. Like, you'll be fine. Implying that you have to go see this movie. Which, no, you don't. And then I said, like, babe, I think it's time to turn off your phone because you're being mean to people on the internet about a movie that's going to make plenty of money with or without us. And then they said, like, no, you should turn off your phone, be an adult, and go sit through a three-hour movie. And then I said, like, crazy how you have time to see a three-hour movie but not enough time to remove the stick from your ass. It could have been a boomer. Their picture was like two, like, young people getting married, and their name was just Jasmine, which makes me think that their name is Jasmine, you know. Does Oppenheimer have cute dogs and great food vids? I think not. No, literally. POV, I tell that person I'm Jewish and I get to choose when I see stressy stuff. I will say conservative people in their 20s are a lot like boomers, and you're not wrong. Anyway, I've already talked about it for too long. But I was like, okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Someone just said it's Al Gore, and they're right. I don't know, and I am too afraid to ask. I think the other thing is it's clearly a joke, because I could just Google it. We all know that. I've been a whiner. You know? Calm down. It's okay. It's actually not that big a deal. I love saying I don't know actors and movie directors. Oh my god, speaking of which, I won't say his name, I guess. I don't think anybody would know, but we recently were at an event where we saw someone we do like, but we don't like their boyfriend. And the boyfriend was like, he does this thing. Y'all know how some men are like, I would just like to talk about what I like to talk about, even though no one's talking about that right now. So I don't remember what we were talking about first. And then he was like, has anyone seen Rick and Morty? And then Phoebe, literally as bitchy as possible, because they were high, looks at him and goes, no, I've never seen it. And then turned around. Are you in here to talk about it now?
Sometimes.
I like your little squeaky voice.
I just woke up.
Hand that to me.
Most of the time, I am a little tranny idiot trying my best with a very hot wife. And that is my identifier. And then sometimes when I'm around cishet men, I'm just a stupid girl. I'm just so stupid girl.
Aww.
But this man literally...
Hey, he sucks.
He sucks so bad.
I don't think there's any reason and why the girlfriend of the person would be here.
I do not have time
but
to have a in-depth conversation about this person. Why, when Rick and Morty came out, I thought it was super fun and I really enjoyed it because I'm someone who enjoys animation and I was like, this is quirky and creative and like silly and like, you know,
as
edgy.
It turns out.
And it turns out it sucks. And it turns out the men who made it suck and they continue to suck. And that leeches into the work that lots of other lovely people worked on, you know? So I don't watch Rick and Morty anymore. But I was so certain this man was going to go on a tangent about Rick and Morty.
He did.
But
he talked to Beau about it for so long.
I wasn't going to be a part of it.
And to be fair, I do think he was saying like...
He's like, this sounded just like this thing.
It was like how we were at this event that we didn't know a lot about the traditions of it. It was a Catholic wedding. Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't
know
the sound.
The Catholic priest sounded like a character from Rick and Morty.
Yes.
Which is fine, and I don't care. But he is like, oh my god, have you guys seen Rick and Morty? And I can tell that he's kind of like focused in on me in a way that makes me uncomfortable. Because at this point, I'm high and just trying my best. And I go, oh my god, no, I've never seen it. And then just like immediately
no, you
turn
are
right back
much
around.
Bitchier than that.
Good. I hate that man. I can't stand him. And you're right, Andy. You are absolutely correct.
I'm just a stupid girl.
Not so binary art. It's because he's like made me talk to him about, I think literally Rick and Morty in the past. So that's the funnier part is that if he has remembered anything about me, he knows I have seen Rick and Morty and that I do know about Rick and Morty. But I don't like that man.
He wants to talk about it a lot and not in like a fun special interest way. And like we were talking about something else and he wants to talk about something he knows about instead.
Yeah.
Way.
I don't care.
And I can't stand him.
He's terrible.
Yeah.
I hate him.
He's just like...
What?
Is it mean to say he's a loser?
The reasons that he is a loser,
I guess we can't talk about it.
We can't discuss, but they are many and they are varied, you know? And I think the problem is, if you have someone in your life who you care about who has just, like, shit taste in partners, and they just, like, continue to, it's hard. There's never a time when you can be like...
I think you need to go back to the drawing board.
Yeah. Like, can you hang out with us? I don't want your shit partner to be there. It's unfortunate, you know what I mean?
Me with men for real?
Squid Ink, it was... Morgan, after the ceremony, Morgan leans over to me and she goes, are you so glad that you married a chaste woman? And I'm like, so glad. Your chasteness was top priority for me.
I also was like, it's really interesting. I think we didn't talk about death enough at our wedding.
Yeah, I think we should have. Yes, it is going on YouTube. I don't think the person will see it.
Yeah.
I think the other thing is that, like, while I have found that... events held in churches, in my experience, specifically Catholic churches especially, are generally not my scene. I do think that, like, I would never want people to feel like I'm out here to shit on a Catholic wedding. Because, like, if you are in love and those things are important to you and those traditions are important to you, like, that is great and totally fine. I think that I was as comfortable in that congregation as I assume my religious family members were at my gay wedding, you know? And we all go to each other's weddings. It's important. They did. They did indeed. It was a lot.
They did do a whole mass. It was actually shorter than I anticipated. Like, it was an hour long, which is still a long time compared to, like a Baptist wedding ceremony is, like, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
25 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's obviously just about the couple. Also, the mass that he did was just about, like, love. And I was worried it was going to be about, like...
They said man and a woman a lot, but they didn't say only a man and a woman, which is also funny because one of the bridesmaids was queer.
And, yeah, like...
She's a lesbian cop, so the bar... I don't have time to unpack any of that, but...
All right, I need something big and flat to flatten my little diamonds out.
Bo and I were certainly the only trans people there, and there was a man with an actual Republican mullet as opposed to, like, a fun gay one. It was a lot. There was a lot going on. And that's okay. Everyone there had a good time. I was very high. It was fine. Yes.
Big difference in mullets. I can't talk.
Didn't do that. Thank God.
At my brother and sister-in-law's wedding, they did, like, wives will submit to their husbands. And what's so funny is, I hate to tell you this, my sister-in-law runs that house.
Oh, yeah.
In a good way. She's very type A, and my brother is obsessed with her. So anything she wants to do, he's like, sounds good.
She also calls him bud condescendingly, and it's so funny.
She does.
As, like, a term of endearment.
She'll be like, I don't know about that, bud.
So funny. Hello, Co. Yes. I would say yes, except for the couple who got married, who looked lovely.
Yeah.
They were beautiful.
They looked great.
It's also, the people getting married, neither of them are the person that we're bitching about. They're lovely. I really enjoy them.
No, I really like them. Hello, welcome.
Hello, hello.
His wife failed to submit, and I was like, this is yuck. And, like, honestly, though, like...
So much.
As someone who grew up in church, if it is important to you, like, I really don't care. Like, I don't. But, like, as someone who is no longer in the church, it is so funny. I've been to multiple weddings where the bride and groom's first kiss was in front of all of us.
Ah!
My boy will submit to me. Literally.
My so god.
Yeah, Phoebe has a little gummy as a little treat sometimes. Horrifying!
Gemini, I didn't want you to say get out.
Yeah.
Automod is anti-horror content.
Can you imagine if it was the husband who cuts off the priest to ask about Rick and Morty?
No, the husband's actually lovely.
Yeah.
absolutely lovely. I do think, yeah, I don't know. There are some members of my family that I make a point to not have any political conversations with. Because I don't want to know.
Yeah.
I don't have time to unpack that right now, you know?
My sister got married in a park, didn't rent the venue, just saw a park and was like, here, and we did it so fast.
That's so funny.
Well, it does mean something different in, like, the Bible than the way that you're thinking of it. And it, so, like, I do get it, but also, like, as someone who's no longer in the church... Oh, exactly. I don't want to know.
Yeah. No.
I don't. It's too... It would be too hard for me to have to see you at Christmas.
Yes.
And that is, like, a huge privilege.
Hello, Dorian. Yeah.
But, yeah. Cute! I have not been to the Redwoods. My little one is it's my birthday week, and I'm working on my Halloween... I mean, my birthday costume.
Your Halloween costume.
Probably my Halloween costume, let's be honest. Working pretty hard.
Yeah.
I need, it's like, cutesy. A book. I need a big, heavy book.
You want something heavy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Me with my father-in-law. Yeah.
I'm just
kidding. Listen, I'm proud of you. Unfortunately, everyone in my family has made their stance known. That's me with my family. You're weaving?
Did you want me to stay?
Yeah.
Oh, I can do that.
I thought you were staying. You can work on your Barbies you're supposed to be working on.
Hey, I can't do that. I don't have water over here.
My grandma's apparently like, why does Riley not talk to us? Maybe if Ruth didn't think I don't deserve rights, I'd say hi.
No, for fucking real.
Oh my god, the bar's so low. That's the thing. Okay.
Okay, you have to let me ignore you to play with my Tamagotchi, though.
Oh my god.
I'm not beeping because I love you.
That is very nice of you to not beep.
I know.
Even though you
even
are
though I'm beeper. Beeper.
Huh? That's so much.
What happened?
I can't read it to you.
Oh.
It's gone already.
Oh.
My sister wants to see me, but really care about my gender rights, so sorry.
Yikes.
No, literally. People want to know about your Tamagotchi.
Oh, I love it. I'm working on a Tamagotchi review TikTok video that will be happening. I want her to get married and have a baby first. That way I can have, like, I can speak to all aspects of the Tamagotchi life cycle. But I'm a big fan, personally. They charge now. They're rechargeable.
Mm-hmm.
And on the Pix, which is the last Tamagotchi iteration before this one, I just had to buy rechargeable batteries. Also, she was, like, beefy as shit. I guess I can grab. Okay, these both have really cute cases on. Well, actually, this one's just covered in glitter. How did that happen? Yes. The CPAP is a Tamagotchi for you, baby.
You're the Tamagotchi.
You're the Tamagotchi. The CPAP is your container. Okay, here's the Tamagotchi on. This is the best Tamagotchi. Unfortunately, it is $300 on eBay. If I can give you any advice right now, any knowledge for you to have, for you to get rich quick, you should buy a single Tamagotchi of the current release and then hold on to it for 10 years, 5 years, whatever. $300. absurd. It's incredible, and the reason this one is so good is because the way that you get different characters is by fucking other Tamagotchis, and then they, like, create these, like, hybridized versions of the Tamagotchis. It's so fun. So fun, so cute.
Tamagotchi hoarding.
It's really good. I think this one takes AA batteries. But anyway, fun and fresh. $200-$300. Bye, John. Thanks for hanging. This is the Tamagotchi On. It's really good. Incredible. This one came out in like 2018, I think. I was not like playing with Tamagotchis in the moment when it happened. Probably because I was in Florida experiencing trauma live. Okay, and then this is the Tamagotchi Pix, which is so silly. It's everything about it is silly goofy. You can take pictures with it like a shitty cell phone. And then, like, it pulls, like, the colors from that photo, which it always thinks is gray or red.
Yeah.
And then it makes food from those things. Very silly. Very unhinged. Battery life so bad. This is why I bought rechargeable batteries. And it's, I mean, it's cute. It's fun. It's silly. It's definitely one I'll come back to. It's very high needs in comparison to other Tamagotchis. But if you, like, want something to hyperfixate on, this is something you can do. I agree, Rude Little Witch. You're so right. Okay. This is the size of the Tamagotchi. Is this okay?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the size of the Tamagotchi before the current release. This is the Tamagotchi Uni. So she's in her little watch thingy right now, so I'll pop her out. But if you look at this, shocking. Gigi Hatamagotchi. We've gone back to the tiny gotchis, which is great because this bitch charges. She's rechargeable. I know. Bitsy, which is really funny because, like, there is not a way for this to look chic. When she's on your wrist, she's fucking huge. It is obviously so much bigger than, like, a Fitbit or anything else. Hold on. Let me put it on for y'all. It's so funny.
Teeny got you. The teeny one is the new one.
The teeny one is the new one.
The big one is the old one.
Ta-da. Tamagotchi on wrist. It's silicone? Silicone? I know, literally an Apple Watch. Very cute. Yes, this little Tamagotchi is rechargeable. This one is just old. Okay, and then the other thing. Here she is. She's very cutesy. I could not for the fucking life of me figure out how to find the clock on here. You just hold this down. Cute, though. Isn't that cute? Fun and fresh. You can wear it as a watch. You can take it off. You can not wear it as a watch. It's got a little, like, thing in the back for one of those, like, cell phone charm thingies. She's $60. And I'm so sorry about that.
It's worth $60
to me. It's so worth $60 to me in a way that's, like, super fucking unhinged, I'm sure, to most other people. Decades of technological development has led to this. She's pixelated, she's cutesy, she's silly. There is a thing with this one where it's not a pedometer in like a stressful wellnessy way, but it does do, she doesn't seem like she should be $60. This one was $60.
Yeah.
And this one's battery life is so bad.
You have to change the batteries like every other day in the old one.
Yes. Anyway, super cutesy, super fun. You can like go on walks with them and do like weird like accessory crafting. You get like one DIY a day for every like 20-minute walk. You take one 20-minute walk a day, you get stuff. A DIY and crafting materials. Every time you go on a 20-minute walk, you get crafting materials.
It's so loud.
It's the worst. It is the worst Tamagotchi auditorily than anyone I've ever seen. And what I don't understand is how, like, there's literally options on here to change the screen brightness, which there was on the Pix as well, but they don't have a volume. So let me turn the sound on for y'all. It's just, like, grating. Are we hearing it, team? Thank you. She's working on a Barbie outfit for her party. Don't fall.
I did.
It is scratchy. More casually being so beautiful in the background. It's scratchy. It's worse when you're playing, like, a game. I turn the noise off of them always, so it's not something that has affected me in a big way.
I wouldn't say always.
Most of the time. The problem is when they're in their baby time age, you have to have the audio on so that you can hit their, like, care whatevers. It's not the Tamagotchi Smart. This is the Uni.
It's the newest one in the U.S.
Yes. It's the most recent Tamagotchi release. Hold on. I think they're only selling them on Amazon. It's $60, which is obviously a lot of dollars. Here she is.
Yeehaw.
Thanks, rude little witch. You're too kind. This is what it sounds like when I'm thinking. Okay, get out of here, buddy. Ta-da. This is what she looks like. There's also pink. And then you can buy additional watch bands, which I guess are butchier. I didn't realize that the colors are so bad. Like, the black is fine, but I want it to be all black. I don't want it to have, like, green additional things. This one's giving very Pokemon, which is fine. There's also these actually very cute lanyards. Did you need help, Overgap?
Well, I cut a little slit.
Okay.
Where I wanted it to be shortened to, and now I've lost the little slit I made.
Do you need help?
No.
You gonna find it?
I'm gonna find it. Don't worry about
it. Okay, good luck. Anyway, I'm having a great time. You could... My problem right now is that what I want is for it to be, like, what's the word? Elastic. I want to be able to, like, stretch it, and it doesn't do that with this little band, which is fine. Thank you, ghost boy. I'm having a great time. I'm thinking about cutting this and making it into kind of like a little, like, fake, like, wrist scrunchie situation with, like, holes here so that it's on, like, fabric and, like, elastic, so I can, like, pull it up farther on my arm when I want to, without having to, like, change the... Also, I feel like silicone, it gets, like, on your skin. It's bad. Sweaty. It's not that it's, like, sweaty.
Oh, I was adding.
Yes. I mean, it can get sweaty. I don't really sweat so much. I don't do anything at all. But it's, like, it's sensory hell. It's, like, scrapey. I thought about that, Echo. I actually was at the thrift store the other day for my Ken costume for the Barbie party. Oh, I should work on mine. That's what I should be doing. Should we make your girly pop a little smaller here?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, I might need your help.
Yeah.
Well.
Yes, exactly, Adventure Erin. That's exactly what it is. How can I help you?
All right, I'll put it back on.
Okay.
And what I need... I need it cut to, like, right here, all the way around.
Okay, including the bottom layer?
Yeah.
Like, to here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hang on, wait.
Oh.
Okay, to, like, here.
Here?
Yeah. Okay. And then I can spin in a circle.
Hold on. I don't know if that's the best idea. Oh my god, this is hard to do.
Yeah.
Okay, put your finger back again. Is that right? Here? Oh, a little higher. Okay.
And then I can even it out.
Can you?
Yeah.
Okay. Hold on. Don't you dare turn. Do not move. You're moving. What?
Nothing. I appreciate your help. You're being so brave.
Oh my god. Stop. Thank
you. You want to move?
Yes.
All right, go ahead. Should we move closer to them?
Sure.
All right, now I'm just
Well, now they can't see the skirt that's being cut.
Now I'm just a torso.
Oh. Okay.
Thank you. I am in my ballerina era. I don't think I'm going to spray this skirt with glitter. Maybe. I have to go buy it is the problem. A collective gay moment. It would be really cute. The problem is it would get everywhere. And it's not just my house, you know what I mean? It's everybody's house. Perfect. But it's not everyone's birthday. You know what? You have a good point. Excellent point. Phoebe's gonna be Ken. Phoebe's gonna be like a classic-y Ken, some might say.
Yeah. I can't post any things about my outfit or how I'm making it because it's close to a movie thing, which we're not supposed to be talking about.
Now, my Barbie, not in any film. Okay, as I'm watching you, I don't know if this is even.
What?
This is where you started.
Oh, no! Oh, no!
Okay, so...
It'll be a little evening out time.
How did you lose, like, 4 inches?
I got scared. Maybe you should have turned. No, you look good! She looks good. Okay, no, I was gonna do that other part. The under part next.
Okay. I need this.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm putting it on my sleeves.
Oh.
Look at her outfit. She's got some on her sleeves.
Okay.
It's French.
It's French. Okay. Okay.
Now, it doesn't look that bad. Because it looks intentional. Like, it's supposed to be longer on the front, shorter on the sides.
Well...
In the camera.
Is this the length you want it to be here? This seems really short.
Yeah.
Your bike shorts to go.
Oh, that's fine.
Okay, good. Okay. Alright. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. Alright.
You want me to hold the tool part?
No.
Okay.
Thank you. I just have to cut with my wrong hand, I guess.
Oh, good.
Well...
How can I help you?
No, it's okay. It's
how
okay.
Can I make this more sexy for you?
Oh my god. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. All right.
A valid question. Now, don't make it too short now.
It's the same length. Did you want to cut it?
No, I guess not. You look like a little bug.
Me?
Yeah, just crawling around.
Oh. Hey, stop. You can't adjust it as I'm doing it.
I will.
No. You're skewing me.
No, you are skewing me.
I'm making it the length that you wanted it to be. Is that wrong?
No, you're
doing... Is it not that?
You're doing a good job.
I'm gonna throw up. Okay.
Should I put my fingers down?
So I'm gonna shit on your head.
Have a frame of reference?
No.
Muppet rage.
Okay, hold on. Spin around. Okay, I think that's actually a good base. Okay,
yeah.
Turn, give me your ass, please. Hold up this part for me. All of it. All of it. Fluffy. Hold, no, 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 no! I need this.
Yeah.
Okay.
also think it's pretty good for eyeballing.
Oh, I found the cut that you made. Give me the front of you. Turn.
Look at my little butt.
Is your butt sticking out?
No, I'm just dancing.
Oh. Put it down. Okay. Stop hitting my head.
Well, I have to hit your head. I must. How's it look?
Cutesy. Come back.
Why are your eyes so scary?
It just looks really stupid.
No.
Just a little.
I'm not going to get lost. Yeah, I'm gonna need little, like, bloomers. Or just tell everyone if you see my ass, you're welcome. Hello, Gemini, welcome. We're doing a great job. It's going really good.
Okay, can you turn a little? Give me your ass. Okay, don't wiggle, bitch.
I must wiggle. I was born to wiggle.
Okay, get me over here. Stop.
You're doing a good job.
Okay, get me closer to the front of you, please. Thank you.
Is this violating any of Twitch's rules?
Okay, give me your front.
Give me your ass. Beeper's entire head in the skirt is, it's very queer-coded here on Twitch today. You are. I love someone just now tuning in. How are you reading from the morgue? What do you mean?
Incredible.
Do you mean from there? I have really good eyesight. That's how. Is it cutesy?
Yes. Okay, but come, stay where you are. Don't move. Just stay. Slow. Stop. What?
You're just so cutesy. You're doing it so well.
I'm a girl dad.
You are a girl dad. You're doing a good job. Hey, careful. Did you hit your little head?
No. Okay. I think that's fine. Stop. Okay. I think that's fine. Stop. I think it's fine.
It looks great.
Okay.
Cute. Nice. Hello. Beeper got that tism riz. Have you heard tism riz?
I have. Don't tell him, but that's how my dad got my He doesn't know.
That's really funny. I'm a little strawberry cupcake. That's me. It's Twirling Ballerina Barbie. Which is who I'm going to be for my birthday party.
I'm all denim Ken. Or we can say, like, classic Ken.
Phoebe is, yeah. Did y'all hear them? Phoebe's being all denim Ken. You may be familiar with him.
Beau's making me an underwear band that says Ken on it, which will be fun.
Yeah. Kenem. Yeah. Thank you, Dorian. Okay. Yeah, I feel like it'll be really...
Beau's gonna be magic
earring Ken. Yeah, Beau's being magic earring Ken, which I'm very excited to see.
It's magic earring Ken.
And that's what I said. This is Sugar. I'm her daddy. It's gonna be a huge sleigh. It's gonna be a win for folks everywhere.
I'm sure we'll have a couple of Magic Earring Kens just because of who we've invited to the party.
That's true. Well, I don't know. Who are all the men-coded people we invited? Because it's only...
That's true.
Nick and Sam, Phoebe's brother and his girlfriend, are gonna be... They're both, like, punk, I guess, and they're just being themselves, which I feel is a cop-out, but I won't tell them. And so they're being punk rock Ken and Barbie. Which doesn't exist, but I won't tell them. I'm just glad they're coming. Shelly's being one from the 60s.
Dad's being an incredible...
Dad's being just, like, a Ken-coded person.
It's
like Malibu Barbie Ken is who he's being.
Yeah, it's his vibe.
He got a wig.
It's incredible.
It is funny they didn't get a blonde wig.
I mean, to be fair, there are brunette Kens.
No, there are, but... Look at ya. Are you gonna fray it?
I'm gonna try. I should have left more to work with.
Yeah, Shelly's being... Shoot, I don't remember the name of her. I don't remember.
She can comment.
Maybe is she watching?
I don't know. Maybe she's not. She was working on something this morning.
She's always working.
I know, boo.
Stupid. It's Barbie. I think it's gonna be really cute. Yeah, I have to sew... That's her name. I have to sew little tool pieces up here. I think my other problem is, like, does this look red?
No.
Does it read as pink?
It's definitely reading as pink, especially with your hair so pink. It doesn't look red to me at all.
Thank you, Piacite. It's so cutesy. Yeah, I don't know how I'm going to make my little crown. I asked Beau, who's really good with 3D shapes, and they said that I should get a cup and, like, use a heat gun. And I do think that makes a lot of sense. Because I don't know if you can see her little crown.
Make her big.
Okay. Do you see how it's like a little, like, cup-y shape?
It looks like a flower.
It does. Yeah, it looks like a flower. You hold her by this, and you spin her, and she can spin on her little toes. That's how she works. Ooh, a pink plastic vase. We should go to Goodwill.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for someone to figure out a Transformer-style costume, except they transform it into the 1993 Barbie Stylite motorhome. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking in her dialogue. I think it'll be cutesy.
What?
What kind of B-Bra are you going to wear?
I think it has to be this one, otherwise my body will hurt. Mm. In a perfect world, I would have a skin tone binder.
Yeah.
I can ask Beau maybe if they have one.
We can also look at Goodwill.
No, I don't think there's going to be anything that's going to be, like, comfortable on me. Mm.
Do Deep greens with reds? Who's red? Do I look red?
It's me. I'm Ken.
It's me. I'm Ken. Classic. Yeah. Yeah, I think I can melt a little cup. I wish I had a...
It's not. It's the free label one. It fucks. It is like a shit ton of dollars.
However...
We got ours for free.
Yes.
Sorry.
We...
I feel like that's obvious when we say something's expensive is that we didn't pay for it. Maybe it's not obvious.
The winner of our blackout... Summer Reading Challenge Bingo.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
They're going to get $100
to free label. $100 to free label.
They messaged us.
Yeah.
And we're like, we're super excited about your Summer Reading Challenge. Can we give you something to give to the winner?
Yeah. They were like, if you guys want a gift card, like, we would be stoked to do that. And we're like, fuck yeah. Which is also really sweet. So I think we'll just have three winners. I think there will be a free label winner, a number one and a number two.
Oh.
You don't want to?
No, I was going to give it all to the winner. Well, because what if we pick two winners? One gift card is for $100 and one's for $50.
I thought we were doing 50 and 25.
Right. So 25 is for the person who wins the drawing of regular 5 space bingo.
Yeah.
And then 50 for the winner of blackout bingo.
Yeah. You wanted to also give them the $100?
Yeah.
Oh.
I feel like they're just one big winner.
Oh, okay. Maybe we chat about it. That's okay.
Yeah.
Not a huge deal. Well, I think it's more fun to spread the love.
No, that's true, but then I feel bad that one person only gets a $50 gift card and one person gets $100.
Oh, they're just going to be excited that they won. I don't think anybody's going to be like... Also, the thing about the $100 is that the $50 is from our actual money that we're paying $50 for a gift card. The $100 from Free Label is their fake money. You know what I mean?
That's true.
And it can only go to Free Label, which is fine. Hello!
Hello.
Blackout could be runner-up.
Whoa.
And then we could do another runner-up? That's true. If you want to make it, like, the most main one. Anyway, sorry. Let me find this bra so y'all can see. It's, a lot of their clothing is, like, is it the sunny one? I don't think it's the sunny. Did they redo it? It's this, isn't it?
I thought. Let me see your back.
No, it definitely, my back looks like this.
What? No, it doesn't.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah.
You wear it backwards.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the Danny bra.
Yeah, it's definitely the Danny one.
It's the Danny bra.
You're 5'7". The walker up.
Okay, they don't have my color anymore, but I'll show you. It's this. I'm wearing it backwards. It's hard to explain. Can we show, do we have another? Yeah. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. So you can wear it like this, or you can wear it like this. And some folks use it as like a maternity bra, because it's like really easy for nursing, because you can just pull your boobie out. And then if you're wearing it like this, the other way, then that part is on your back and is like a pretty little like cross back thingy. Thank you, Pendlas. You're too kind, baby. You're so sweet.
Sometimes anyway, it's you just really need a boobie out.
It's a really good bra. It is, like, entirely cotton, so, like, you can see my...
Oh, they can't see it.
Oh.
No, you can show it. Sorry, I just mean you need to scoot.
No, it's, like, sometimes you just need a boobie out. It's, the, like, what's it called? It's not sweat. It's, like, deodorant.
Yeah, like, the underarm
normal. Yeah, the underarm, yeah. It just continues to look like underarms, but I don't feel like people see it that much, so I'm not really worried about it. Yeah, it's cute. It's comfy.
We should buy you more, because they're the only bra you really want to wear.
It's my favorite. It's so comfy. They're $100.
Now, what we should do is ask if they want to hire us again.
Yeah.
I love their stuff. I live in their stuff.
Yeah, well, that two-piece set, the forest green one, is from them.
Yes. I want it a different color. My only complaint is that they only make things in, like, dark colors. And I need them to work with some pinks.
They're doing, like, neutrals. Lavender. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Although they did do some fun plaid pants.
Yeah, I got the ad for them the other day.
Yeah. They're cute. You also like the... You have a jumpsuit from them, too,
I
right?
I do, and I love it.
Do Do their shorts have pockets? No. Bastards. I can't live.
Universal standard ones do, though, and they're really nice.
I cannot live without
pockets. What size did you get?
In the bra? That's a great question. I think it's a 2X. Will you look? Oh, maybe it's here. Oh, I don't know if it's anywhere.
If it is, it's on the bottom, so your boobie would come out.
Hold on.
At least that's how mine is. No, I think it's on the side on the bottom.
On the side on the bottom?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I got that Tism Riz.
What are you singing? Oh, here we go.
The Tism Riz song.
Oh no. This thing's gone. I think it's a 2X. Well, I think so too. It's an XL.
Phoebe's wearing an XL.
I'm wearing an XL. I sized down on purpose because I wanted it to squish me. It is not uncomfortable at all. Hold on. I have my measurements, so let me look at the measurements of this and tell you how much I sized down. If it's going to stress anybody out to hear about numbers right now, then you might want to hop out for one moment.
Yeah, mine's a 3X for sure. Mine's a 3X and everything except one time I got a pair of pants from them and they didn't fit. And then they sent me a 4X. And then we sent back the 3X.
She did. Cute. Sorry. I got distracted.
Meat. Hey.
I have a lot of normal things. Okay. Yes. Okay, so my boobies.
What?
Hey. Read them the full note.
Well, we missed it.
This is what this entire note
okay,
says.
Don't, because it's got all our passwords on it, you silly woman.
No, it doesn't.
It does down here.
Right. I'm not reading all that.
I thought it was
you can't
up there.
See it.
I don't even know who that is, so okay, don't say their name.
This?
Yeah, I don't know.
You don't know who it is?
No, so don't read their name. Don't dox them.
Okay. This is one note. It says July 17th, Twitch-iversary. 8/27, TikTok-iversary. Space. Bob size. Tummy 16. Neck 9.5. Length 1.
I don't know what happened there. I had his length at one point.
Morg size. B-O-B 54. Waist 50.5, ass 59. Phoebe size, boobie 46, waist 41, ass 48. Someone's full name, who we don't know in real life, and then four numbers.
And then
all of our passwords. What's this?
I think it's coordinates, but I don't know what for.
Do you just have one note?
What?
Go back. What are your other notes?
This one says meat.
It's showing me. What's wrong with you?
I was shopping.
For 5 things?
Yeah.
You only got 2 of them.
I did get them all. I just forgot to cross them off. You should be careful when sizing down with binder breaks. I'm so sorry. The important part of this that I was trying to tell y'all, Juanitas are so good, is that the size for the 2X is 46 to 49 for bust. And I am right at like the lower edge of that. Does that make sense? And then my waist fits within the XL, I think. I might be 42. I don't know.
My notes, hand me my phone.
Hold on. I don't know why they're coordinates. All I'm trying to say is I was essentially like between sizes on this and size down. It's not that I was at the higher end of 2X and got an XL. I'm still trying to be able to breathe. Does that make sense to the team, to the class? I just knew that I would want to wear the slightly smaller one to like compress just a little bit. But it's not, I'm not doing anything dangerous with my chest. Okay. It's important to be careful with your body. Go ahead.
These are my notes.
I'm so sorry, Lenny.
First of all, mine are all labeled.
Okay.
You know what? Maybe I won't read them out loud. I forgot I had that one. There's only one.
yesterday.
It's a note. It is a note. And the title is corn videos. But not corn. And then there is a link to cornhub.com. It is just the one.
It's just this one girly that I really like.
You didn't call the note corn. You called the note corn videos. And then you put one video.
Yeah. I've been looking for it for a long time.
That's so funny. Jesus fucking Christ.
It's called my to-do list.
I'm so sorry. Thank you, Seven.
Okay, anyway, other than that one.
I appreciate you.
I have reading log. I have summer reading challenge, which is all the rules in case I need to copy and paste them.
Yes.
I have our passwords. I have discount codes. I have a list of art ideas. I want to make some art, but I haven't gotten there yet. A list of addresses. A list of the food I want to eat in Disneyland.
Important things.
Yeah. And then... this is my list of problems with Asteroid City.
Tell them, read them your list of problems.
Okay, it just says notes, because I should have written Asteroid City at the top.
Okay.
Autism. Background silence. Too many words, question mark, question mark, question mark. Little snippets of convies, no context. Nobody laughs or is having a good time. Little behind the scenes facts with no context or answers, question mark, question mark. What is the point, question mark, question mark? It took 1 hour to introduce the interesting core of the story. Everyone is a manic pixie dream girl if they were shot with a sadness ray.
That's no spoilers, Asteroid City.
Yeah.
And you're right. And it's fair. Sometimes, you know, sometimes it's just like that.
I also have one that says stuff I want to buy. And then I have one called Inventions. There's only two inventions on it, though.
And what are your inventions?
My inventions are the heavy straw. Heavy so it doesn't fly up in your Coke. I also have flattening / spinning straw, which is to flatten Coke.
You have a lot of Coke-based inventions.
I also have scary things. These absolutely are the scary things I put on my list.
Go ahead.
The gorillas...
not the animal, the band.
Those really long face dogs. Really light green moss. Bears.
That is true.
Thank you.
The things I know about you are that you're afraid of all those.
Things I can do right now with no training. Contemporary dance. Professional hula hooping at a festival. That giant hoop you can stand in and roll around on. Those are things I'm convinced that I could do with no training. Is it true? No, I'm sure not.
It's not to say that those things aren't hard, yeah.
But in my brain, I'm like, I could do that.
Oh, my so god.
This is when I woke up. Do you remember when I woke you up in 2021 and said I had a dream about a movie and then I wrote down the movie? Yes. This is that movie.
Oh, my god. You were like, we have to write this.
Yeah, when I woke up on purpose later, I was like, this movie's kind of boring.
Yeah.
But I kept it. I think it's funny.
Oh my god.
This is absolutely a Leo's Notes app. Okay, but they're all labeled, and they all stay... and they all stay separate.
No. I have, like, two notes that I use.
I have one that's... I'm so mad they burnt my croissant!
Hello, Lunar Raccoons. Listen. Here we are.
Phoebe's are really funny. Phoebe also has quites. My other favorite thing is Phoebe doesn't correct things that they spell wrong in the note.
I don't have time for that. My name's Phoebe. My pronouns are they, them.
My name's Morgan. My pronouns are she, her. If you'd like to share your name and your pronouns in the chat, you can, but also you don't have to. My Google Docs has something titled Fucked Up Train.
Did you sell it to Colleen Ballinger? Is that what happened? Listen. Fun and fresh.
I'm only interested in Bob's notes.
He doesn't take notes. His head is so...
I didn't know you could lock notes.
Yeah, how do you lock it?
How would you lock?
How do you make it a secret?
In the way that music shouldn't be for everyone.
I do in my Quites app, I have...
Your Quites app?
In my Quites note, I have the words that Morgan has made up.
Oh, I lock my corn ones. I'm happy for you. Listen, if someone broke into my phone, they'd be like, what an excellent film. This woman worked very hard for 35 minutes. I'm happy for her. I've never known what the last 33 minutes of it are, but I'm sure the rest of them are good. Okay. That's not my business. Morgan's super French fry. So true.
Welcome to stream. It's weird today.
No, I'm normal. The first 40 seconds of the video, top notch. It's not just her. She's got someone working with her, but I feel she's doing all the work. She's certainly the star. Normalize not knowing the plot of the movie because the beginning is so good.
Here we are.
What were we gonna say?
How should I fray this?
Oh, you take scissors and you like...
Oh.
So you, like, open them all the way?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh.
You clearly didn't work in a costume shop. It could end with the rapture and I'd be none the wiser. All right.
That's kind of hard.
It is. I have to go clean out the kitchen upstairs. Which I'm sure will be really fun for everyone. Phoebe has to go fray their little jean jacket, I guess.
I know it's kind of silly that it's striped, but it was the only light wash one. And they had jean jackets for $25 at the Goodwill. And I was like, Jesus Christ.
I thought you were just going to take the light wash one that we have here.
No, I love it.
Oh.
I love that one.
That's fine.
You want me to ruin it?
No.
You hate me.
You don't wear it.
I do, when it's cold. But right now, it's hot.
I have a lock note that was titled London, and it's literally just my travel plans and venue information. Why did I think that had to be a secret at 3 a.m.?
That's so funny.
The Goodwill is just turning into a store lately.
It's annoying. It's annoying and it's stressful to me. Stop doing that, the Goodwill.
Afraid. Fraud not! Wow. Inner dialogue.
I'm scared.
Yeah. Value Village is the same. Honestly, all of them are the same.
I feel like Value Village has been like that, though.
The only time that we get, like, really good deals on things are, like, estate sales.
Oh, no. I didn't want both your hands. Just one of them.
I feel like this is a bad noise for everyone.
No, they like it. You don't understand.
I was in Goodwill this week, and that was when I realized my cat had peed on my shirt.
Oh, that's terrible, baby.
That's so sad. Okay, I do have to go clean the kitchen, though.
Okay, but for right now, you just have to hold this right here.
I don't think that's what I have to do.
Thank you.
I don't remember. I don't think that's in my contract.
I think it literally is. Why is this so hard?
Well, because there's not a lot to work with.
Hey. What?
Oh, my back hurts.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Probably from holding up these huge knockers.
Okay.
Kitchen Barbie.
Cute.
She doesn't know. The cat piss is not part of the shirt, lady.
She's got no idea.
It's an accident.
No idea.
Now, this is a cute little thing.
Yeah, I might wear it.
It's a cute little getup. Just a scritching and a scratching.
Sometimes you gotta.
They're trying to fray the edges.
Yeah. I am doing that with scissors. Should I not? That's what Morgan said to do.
Yeah. It might be better if you cut, like, cut little things for something for you. Like cut it a little deeper, you know?
No.
You gotta dig a little deeper. My hat's a Carby or Ben. Behaps it is.
Behap?
Behaps it is that. I was about to come in and be like, this is dangerous. Seven's always showing up being like, this is dangerous.
And it's right.
Or Seven will be like, I don't know if you're legally allowed to do that. And I'll be like, what do you know? You're not my lawyer.
It is my boss, though.
Yeah. Sorry. I am going to make a little crown. Not right this second. I don't know if anyone's going to be Alan. I have no idea who anyone else is going to be. I like to bring the opposite energy to stream roll with scissors. Seven literally is the Goop CEO.
It is.
A non-profit CEO. I'm just here.
I don't know if it counts as non-profit. It's just not making good money. Seven profits a very small amount
every
month.
We are not talking about films that we haven't seen. Or have seen.
Hold on. Don't be so weird. What's the exclamation point? Is it Barbie?
Barbie, yeah. Okay, you wrote Narno.
I didn't write Narno. I would never write Narno.
What is Narno?
None of your business. Anyway. Content creators are not supposed to talk about the movie. There's not boycotts against movies.
Yeah.
But per the strike guidelines, it's considered like promotion for content creators, even organically, to talk about the movie.
Yeah.
So whether or not we loved the movie, we cannot say. Whether or not we've seen it multiple times, we're also not able to say.
No. My birthday party is just Barbie themed. It's not Barbie movie themed.
Yes.
So we are allowed to talk about that.
Yes. Thanks, Gemini.
Period.
Period. Yeah, we'll have a lot of very fun Barbie content coming out about the party.
Yeah.
Because there's a box that's been almost done being made. There's some signs. Should be good. Are we doing the putting things in the outside today?
No.
What day are we doing that?
Thursday.
Oh. Did you put it on the Google calendar?
No, I just made it tiny.
Barbie.
We said we were gonna have a birthday party for Bob. Here's a problem.
There's a lot of stuff going on.
There's other things happening.
We'll have a small family get together and TikTok video for Bob's birthday, I believe. The inheritor of Manhattan.
Of Manhattan.
No, you're perfect.
I will have a birthday stream probably on Monday. I know we normally have Mondays off. But I do think it's fun to have a birthday stream.
Fuck it up. He will be a Bobby girl in a Bobby world.
I know, we have to get him something. Like,
I was going to say, he's going to have a sweet little treat also.
Bob could be Alan.
He'd be an incredible Alan.
That's not a bad idea. Okay. I love you. I appreciate you. Thank you for being here.
Yeah.
Have a good day. Will you click this?
Oh, I can. Okay.
Goodbye.
I love you. Goodbye.